Welcome back, Chris. I know it's been a little bit of a frustrating stretch, I guess, for you the last couple results.
Just a little bit.
Yeah, what do you take out of that, right? Because I mean, especially in the heavyweight division, right? It seems like you just go, well, it's heavyweight, but
shit happens, man. It's a heavyweight division. Just in fighting in general, you really can't, you know, dwell on those losses. You have to take every fight as they come, and that's pretty much what I've been doing, just trying to do, especially with this fight. So whatever happens, happens. I'm definitely looking to win, obviously. I'm not trying to fly out somewhere and get my ass kicked, so definitely looking to fuck somebody up. So
is it easy to do that, Tad? I mean, I know you've been in more stressful situations than a cage fight, so is it easy to move past it, or is it hard to like not dwell on it?
I mean, like, after you lose the first month and a half, I want to kill myself because it fucking sucks. Everyone's telling me how bad I suck, and like everyone's just like shitting on you because that's what people do. You're only as good as your last fight, and my last two fights I've sucked. So yeah, I mean, you just have to get through that. I mean, it sucks, but yeah, it's just, you have to get through that, and that's what I've been working on that since my last one, and I'm here to change that.
Love it. Obviously, we were supposed to see you a couple months ago. There was a change in schedule. I guess, what happened with the change in schedule? I don't think I saw what...
From the best of my knowledge and my team's knowledge, it was on his end. They asked for a different date, so I'm not one to shy away. I told the UFC that if they could find me a fight, you know, instead of that one, on the same day, I would do it. If I had to wait a month, I would do that. But the UFC seemed that they really wanted to make us two fight, so they pushed it to Saturday.
Is it a matchup that you like? I mean, were you like, oh, good, we get to keep it, or did it matter to you?
Doesn't matter. I honestly don't care who I fight. Like, I could have a change in opponent for Saturday, and it's just another day. Doesn't matter to me.
What do you think about him as a fighter? I mean, obviously, he's got a lot of power, but everybody does at heavyweight, right?
So absolutely.
I guess, what do you think about him as far as danger-wise, you know, how you guys match up?
He's definitely super skilled. He's definitely dangerous in a lot of positions. But, you know, we've been working this camp to take away and limit that danger. I mean, that's really what – I'm not going in there and banging it out with this dude. It's just – that would be dumb on my part. If that happens, I failed at my job, and I should probably look for a new career. But – you know, saying that, I really do like this, but I like this matchup, but I just have to be smart about everything, as with all fights, especially heavyweights.
Last thing for me, I guess, the importance of this. I mean, are you putting extra emphasis on, like, this means a lot to me, or is this just another fight?
This is another fight. Obviously, every fight means, you know, the world to you at the time. Everyone knows we're not employees by the great UFC. They can cut us at any time. They can terminate a contract at every time. And I treat every fight like it's my first and last fight because something could come up and they could be in a mood or I could have said something and next thing you know, I'm looking for a job. So,
Chris, to your right.
Yep.
I just, you know, one question, just what you referenced about the people saying you suck and whatnot. Do you respond to that? Like, do you take time to say, you know, anything to them or you just, like, ignore it?
No, I want to respond, but I know that that's what people want. They want you to get to respond. So I try my best to not respond at all. I mean, it's gonna ruin my day, and like my wife would be like, "Were you reading comments again?" And I'm like, "Yeah, I was reading comments again." So yeah. I mean, but no. As far as actually physically replying to people, no. Unless they say some atrocious shit, I'm not replying to anything.
Thank you. There's in the front right here. Jared, going off of that, Jared Gordon was here, and he said that he feels Americans tear down their athletes, while when you have guys like Habib and Charles Oliveira, these guys. They have a whole country behind them, even when they lose. But for Americans, they just want to tear their athletes down. I'm curious if you agree with that statement as an American athlete.
Definitely. That I feel that there's a bigger support for athletes who are not American, no matter what. It seems like the whole country rallies behind those athletes. A reasoning behind that, I couldn't tell you. I mean, it's just the way that American sports fans are in general. Maybe we're super, like, clicky, like, take the NFL. Like, if I'm from, you know, Philadelphia, I only care about the Eagles. Everybody else sucks. Dallas sucks. Really don't care about anybody else. Giants really sucks. Yeah, I get the fuck out of here. Anyway, I think that we take that as, like, putting that kind of mindset towards fighting. So, yeah.
Chris.
What's up, brother? How are you?
I'm good, man. First of all, are you happy that you're not in a main event? And you can finally
I can finally like not worry about a 5-round fight. Like training for a 5-round fight suck. I don't know if people have done it, but that shit fucking sucks. Like, don't do it.
What's the mind state like when, like, you know, you quit your job as a police officer, you know, you get a salary, you're very comfortable, and then you lose two fights. Like, what's the mindset like?
Like, dude, you totally fucked up. Like, you probably should have stayed a cop. But no, I mean, this is what I wanted. This is really, you know, what I've been striving for. It's what I want. I would rather do this, get my ass kicked, and question whether or not I have a job than to go back to the police department. I mean, I love the police department. I don't love the police department. I love the people I work with. The whole bureaucracy and all that, that's a whole different story. But no, I really enjoyed the people that I worked with. But this is much better. I get to spend time with my family. I get to spend time with my kids. Like, this is living the dream for me. I get paid to get into fistfights. And yeah, I wouldn't change it for the world.
And finally for me, there's this fascination. Can you make 205 or no fucking way?
No, I talked to my brother. I can make 205. But yeah, I've been speaking with a nutritionist. I've been using, my brother uses John Poppy, who's out here in Vegas. He told me, obviously it's going to have to be a lifestyle change. Certain things would change. But if you guys remember when I fought in Abu Dhabi, I weighed in at 225. He said, if you come in fight week weighing 225, you can make 205, no problem. So that is an idea that's been floating around in my head, but we'll see where things go. I mean, is it always good to change weight classes? No. You have to take into account that the 205 guys are probably a little bit more technical than the heavyweight guys. Have probably not hit as hard, certain people. So we'll see. We'll see where this goes. But as of right now, I'm staying at heavyweight, and I don't have any plans to go to 205. But unless something drastically changes in my life or career, we're staying here.
Awesome. Thanks, man.
Of course. All good? All right. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.